Welcome to SBS News in Easy English. I'm Greg Diet. Police in Lismore have found the body of a man in the town's main street. It's the third death in the flood emergency in New South Wales. More heavy rain is expected today. And southeast Queensland is also expecting more rain. Five people are reported dead after a blast at the main TV tower in the Ukrainian capital. It took place after Russia warned residents of Kyiv it was preparing to hit targets in the city. The blast followed a military strike in Ukraine's second largest city, Kharkiv, which hit an apartment complex near a hospital. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky says Russia must stop bombing Ukrainian cities before talks on a ceasefire can resume.
As for dialogue, I think yes, but stop bombarding people first and start negotiating afterwards. It's necessary to sit at the negotiation table with the Russian president while there's still readiness to hold talks with him.
Germany's foreign minister, Annalena Baerbock, has told the United Nations General Assembly that Russia's invasion of Ukraine is based on lies. In her address, she condemned Russia's actions as ones that violate the peace principles of international law.
You say Russia is to protect Russian-speaking from aggressions. But today, the whole world is watching as you are bombing the homes of Russian-speaking Ukrainians in Kharkiv.
Representatives from the United Nations Human Rights Council have walked out in protest against Russia's Foreign Minister, Sergei Lavrov. Officials denounced his pre-recorded speech that justified the attack on Ukraine, criticizing it for containing misinformation. United States Secretary of State Antony Blinken told the council human rights abuses and violations are increasing.
We must reject Russia's attempts to falsely justify this attack as a defense of human rights. Misappropriating terms that we reserve for the worst atrocities and disrespecting every victim of those crimes.
Minister Lavrov had planned to attend in person, but could not make it after European airspace was closed to Russian aircraft. Victoria has recorded a further 28 COVID-19 deaths and 7,126 new cases. New South Wales is reporting another 5 COVID deaths and 10,650 new infections, up from Tuesday's number of 8,874. The ACT is also seeing an increase in coronavirus infections, with 1,053 recorded. And Queensland has reported 24 COVID-19 deaths and 5,011 new cases. Tennis champion Novak Djokovic and his coach Marijan Varga have announced they are no longer working together, splitting after 15 years and 20 Grand Slam titles. Djokovic says they agreed to end their partnership after last year's tennis finals. I'm Greg Diet, and this is SBS News in Easy English. Welcome to SBS News in Easy English. I'm Greg Diet. New South Wales Premier Dominic Perrottet says 500,000 people are subject to either flood warnings or evacuation orders. More rain is expected in the Hunter, Central Coast and Sydney. Dean Naramore from the Bureau of Meteorology warns heavy rainfall on coastal locations can lead to life-threatening flash flooding.
We're expecting 50 to 150 millimetres today in that part of the world, and we could also see isolated totals in excess of 200 millimetres, particularly with any thunderstorms.
In the coastal town of Ballina, thousands of homes have been flooded. Mayor of Ballina Shire Council, Sharon Cadwallader, says phone reception is poor and the internet is off.
We're in the thick of it here, and it's just terrible to think that in this day and age that we haven't got a better communication system when we're so reliant on it.
Thunderstorms and hail in southeast Queensland are likely to lead to more flooding. These are the worst floods in 10 years, with more than 17,000 homes and businesses damaged and 9 deaths. Western Australia has reopened its borders after months of being cut off from the rest of the world. The state will welcome people who have had 3 COVID-19 vaccinations from other parts of Australia and from overseas. World Vision Australia says it's helped dozens of children evacuate Kyiv after an orphanage was bombed and destroyed by Russian forces. So far, more than 874,000 people have fled the fighting in Ukraine in the 7 days since Russia invaded. World Vision Australia's Daniel Wordsworth told SBS News the situation is likely to worsen.
We expect over the next few weeks maybe another 200, up to 1,500 orphan children who are going to need homes outside of Ukraine.
Australia will join 30 countries in releasing a combined 60 million barrels of oil from their supplies to bring down prices. The price of petrol has increased following Russia's invasion of Ukraine. Russian billionaire Roman Abramovich has announced he plans to sell the Chelsea Football Club. He has owned the club for 19 years and has always denied claims he has links to Russian President Vladimir Putin. I'm Greg Diet, and this is SBS News in Easy English.
This is SBS News in Easy English. I'm Claire Slattery. A 10th person has died in Queensland's flood disaster. The body of a 53-year-old man was found overnight under a wharf in the port of Brisbane. Severe storm warnings in the state's southeast have now been downgraded, but the Bureau of Meteorology says the chance of flash flooding remains. Queensland's Premier, Anastasia Palaszczuk, says climate change is driving the state's unprecedented flooding.
Let's face it, it's climate change. I mean, I've never seen so many natural disasters. We seem to be dealing with more and more cyclones, more floods. But we're a great state, we're a resilient state, and, you know, I'll tell you what, one thing is the people of this state inspire me every day.
Queensland has announced its first human case of Japanese encephalitis. Queensland Health confirmed the infected person is being treated in a Brisbane hospital and had recently travelled to regional southern Queensland. Currently, there are 16 cases of encephalitis under investigation across New South Wales, Victoria, and South Australia. The Department of Primary Industries is urging anyone who works with pigs or horses to report any signs of the disease. A fire has broken out at Europe's biggest nuclear power plant after it was attacked by Russian forces. The plant in Enerhodar in Ukraine's south accounts for one quarter of the country's power generation. A plant spokesman says that background levels of radiation have not changed, but there were casualties. Russia has already captured the Chernobyl plant, some 100 kilometres north of Ukraine's capital, Kyiv. Meanwhile, the United Nations says 1 million people have fled Ukraine in the week since Russia invaded the country, while many more have been internally displaced. The UN estimates that 2% of Ukraine's population of 44 million people has been on the move this past week. The United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees, Filippo Grandi, is warning if the conflict continues, that number could get as high as 4 million people.
I have worked in refugee emergencies for almost 40 years, and rarely have I seen an exodus as rapid as this one.
Members of the LGBTIQ+ community and their allies are preparing to sparkle at the annual Mardi Gras parade in Sydney under the theme United We Shine. Thousands of marchers and more than 160 floats will take part in the event on Saturday, celebrating queer culture and highlighting the need for social equality. First Nations comedian Stephen Oliver is anchoring the parade, and he says Indigenous inclusion is important.
Well, you got the First Nations float stuff there like that. So, you know, the Aboriginal people from all over Australia as well as Torres Strait Islander mob and stuff like that, you know, which I like to nickname Fab-Originals and Torres Strait Stylanders.
Australian cricket great Rod Marsh has died, aged 74. It's understood that Marsh suffered a heart attack and was rushed to hospital in a critical condition last week. Marsh played 96 tests for Australia from 1970 to 1984. You've been listening to SBS News in Easy English. I'm Claire Slattery.